here on a roundabout, there's even, you know, the compass, you know. So it can't be, you know, and look at the V sign of the Templars. And of course, this is a Freemason sign, and the Freemasons came out of the Templars. So what more you want, you know?
I hitchhiked until 1 o'clock in the night. There's a motorway. I'm not on the right track here. There's a petrol station on the other side. And there's my petrol station there in France. Cell phones, not good for the bees. You should do like this with the cell phone masts. Pull them down. Well, it's good here. So this is a Scania truck with a lion, you know, and a crown. So it's the aristocracy, and there's a hexagon in it, you know. It's the aristocracy ruling the whole world. They always did. This is Pharaoh. There never were any lions. So here's a Polish guy in the truck. He's taking me hitchhiking. And here, you know, the truck next to it, it's a man, another lion. It's full of lions, you know, there never were any lions. So it's a foreign power over ruling over, like, over Europe. So I'm waiting for my Polish driver. They're nice people. He's offering me I was sleeping there, he's offering me a cup of tea. So I'm here in a quick hamburger restaurant on the motorway. And I got two hamburgers with a ticket I got, you know, from a fireman, you know, a French fireman. He was a rugby player, he gave it to me. And I got, so I ate three here, and I got about four hamburgers. I already ate one here, a whole bag full, you know. I got it for free because they're closing. So I got three hamburgers for tomorrow, and about four hamburgers for free. It's not bad. I saw they were closing, so, you know. All the hamburgers still lying there, so, you know, why not feed the pig with it, you know? Here they are, you know? That's a toll road. The road toll. Sure we can. Well, I know what, I wonder what it means, you know, if you hear it backwards, because we all know, yes we can, what we hear, you know, if you hear it backwards at some sort of a TV station or something. So I'm here in Albanga again. Well, the aristocracy is ruling. There's another toll road here in Italy. It's a small one. I went hitchhiking with this guy. Crazy. He got a terrible V8 in the pickup, man. I did miles and miles, you know, like squeeze into this thing. My backpack in the back was fantastic. Fantastic, man. But I was happy. Terrible V8 pickup, man. I think we did 10 miles an hour, like crawling up the mountain. Fantastic. No, I really enjoy that. Yeah. Nice old man. Well, that looks like a big toad. It looks a bit tired though. Whoa. Probably hitchhiking. You know, well, some good steak on it, you know, on his hind legs. Frenchies eat it. Look at the steak. Yeah. Good thing the Frenchies don't see it because I'm in Italy. So even here, I'm in the middle of some French forest here. There's a sun hieroglyph in the other form, like this, the square sort of form. There's my old backpack. Well, here's some other things here. I don't see what this all means here. Maybe I'll see it later when I look at it again. It's quite weird. So there's some for the electricity. So I'm in the middle of France. Some ferries, some forest here. It has been snowing. I mean, I'm April now, the end of April. So in barrage. Now, last night in my tent, I woke up and I was like, it's hurting down there, you know? So I had a look, I felt first, and I thought, so I had a look, I had to get out of my dust bag, my sleeping bag, and I had a tick on my balls, and now it's all swollen up. It feels like I've got an extra pair of balls, you know, like three balls are down there, you know. So excuse me if I'm not going to film it for you. Pharaoh. Aristocracy. Castle. Me. So just before I met some real nice people there. There's a lot of, you know, camping cars there. They invited me for a coffee. I just slept here, you know, on a sporting ground, and really nice people. Their son, you know, he went on a bicycle from France to Australia, you know, passing Asia and everything. Now their son, he's working in the helping people, you know, immigrants in somewhere in the east of Europe. So here they are very, you know, they are here, the pharaohs, you know. The obelisk represents Osiris, and here's the River Nile, the water representing Isis. And Seth, I already told you the story of Isis and Seth. The Horus Matrix, Seth was, he cut, so Seth or Set on, Satan, he cut Osiris in 13 pieces. And his friends tried to find his pieces in the his body parts in the River Nile, and the 13th part, his sexual organ, they could never find it again, and this is why the phallic symbol here was made on his behalf of the missing part, like, you know. And again, it was the 13th part, as the attacks in Paris on Friday the 13th, etc. Well, I already told you that. And here are their descendants, you know, the aristocracy. So real next to the castle, I'm gonna film it just afterwards. They're all here, you know, next to the obelisk and the River Nile. Osiris, Isis, it's all here. They're the ones who are ruling over us, like, yeah. Right. What a fantastic tree. It must have been already here like hundreds of years ago, during the times of the knights in shining armor. So this looks not like a very, this is not an old castle. So this the crescent moon in the in this thing here. So why? So this is the sun hieroglyph here in the castle. The tree here, the big tree, is a cedar from Lebanon. You can see it's a very hard wood. They make guitars out of it. You see, these are not different leaves. No, like a pine. I'm entering this place here next to the castle. You know, it's part of the castle. I'm probably not supposed to be here. So this is the town here, Haute-Rive. And there is a guy who built a castle, a pharaonic sort of castle here. I'm not sure if I get in, but I'll try. Hey. So this is the place I told you about the postman who built his own pharaonic sort of castle. So there he is, the postman. So he went like delivering the mail, and every time he came back, he took a lot of rocks with him. You know, like here, all these rocks. Maybe he did this as well. And he built a castle with it over a period of 30 years or something. Every day
He said, well, that's a work, a Pharaoh's work, you know, the Pharaoh's way of thinking, you know. If I take a couple of stones every day, I'll have a couple of tons by the end of it, you know. And here it's very pharaonic here. You feel it, you know, it says over there, you know, like where the bench is, it said, don't drink any alcohol, don't do this, don't do that. So there it is, that's a castle he made. You know, it looks like the Borobudur or something, like an Indian temple, you know. Well, let's see if I can get in. Oh, you see, there it is, you know, there. French built his own pharaonic castle. You know, you just saw the obelisk, the other castle. So, you know, they're here. They're definitely here, you know. Yeah, one of them. But there it is, his castle. He was living in it, you know. Now, let's see. I see the postman. So there it is again, you know. The postman always rings twice, like. There again, you can see the parcel, you know, the castle. He was probably the postman, but also a pharaonic descendant. He said, well, you don't give me any power, I'm going to build my own castle, like, you know. So, he was kind of a sweet pharaoh, I suppose. So here you can see all these artists, you know, who had a concert, like in here. You know, like, I don't know, Robin McKelly. You know. See, it's fantastic, huh? A lot of international artists. So here's another hole in the thing. So, you can have an idea, you know, what it looks like. So the guy was living in it. So over 30 years or like, he built his own castle. Like every time picking a few stones on the way back when his bag was empty, you know, with the mail delivered. So really, I asked the lady if she would let me in, but they didn't. So it looks like a Hindu temple, you know. So I can't see the LCD screen. I hope you can see it. So this is the story about this guy here. There's too much sun in it, you know. Can't see the LCD screen. So apparently here you can see a picture of the guy in the he worked 33 years on his castle, and he was born in 1879. He lost a couple of his children, and he had to walk like 40 kilometers every day, you know, to deliver the mail. And on his way back he filled up the pockets, you know, his bag with stones, and he built the entire castle. But the interesting thing here is, if you look at the castle, I can hardly see it, you know, because there's too much light in the LCD screen, but I'll try, you know. It says Egyptian tomb, well, it's written wrong, but never mind. It says Swiss chalet, the White House. I mean, this guy is initiated, otherwise the White House, you know, that's the Perhet, it's Upper Egypt, it's the White Crown. I just saw the obelisk here, there's a castle, he's a member of it all, you know. And he was not recognized, I suppose, you know, to be initiated into more, you know, to get recognized into the whole thing. Well, it says Egyptian tomb, the Swiss chalet, so he knew, you know, their base is Switzerland, the White House, and now the man in the White House is of Swiss descent. This is all, this guy knew what he was doing, he absolutely knew it. And if you see it, you know, how it is now commercialized here. I tried to get in without paying, well, they didn't let me in. If you see all those artists here, you know, like here, you know, it's the pharaonic temple. This guy is pharaonic descendant, you know. But they didn't recognize him as such, so he said, well, I'm going to build my own parcel. I do this. I'll show you that I'm a pharaoh, I'm one of you, I'm one of yours, you know. And then you'll recognize me. So now he's dead. I know, he's dead. He died in, I don't know, somewhere in the 1940s or 1930s.
So here it says, the Egyptian temple. One of them. So here we can see Frenchie waiting to get into the museum. It was like being in Russia or something. Film you all. Vous savez, mesdames, messieurs, les attentats à Paris, ce sont tous des opérations sous fausse bannière pour donner un prétexte pour un guerre géostratégique, pour le pétrole. C'est tout menti. C'est pour ça qu'on dit parlement, ça vient de parler et mentir. Ce sont des parlementeurs. Ce sont les Suisses qui sont derrière. Parce que la Suisse a été fondée par des Templiers en 1291. Alors vous êtes tous des moutons. You know, so the cops came, you know, because I was talking to Frenchy and I said, you know, the attacks were just false flag attacks, so they call up the cops, you know. Nice. In French, les Schmitts, ils sont arrivés. Here, like hitchhiking here, I'm hitchhiking with this guy here, and there's another crazy French here who lost his wife, and I think he lost his child or something. So he put all these children things here. You know, I saw it like, and here as well, fascinating. So this is next to the other guy, you know. So yeah, I'm hitchhiking with this guy here. Oh, cameras everywhere. It's just a little village here. So here's another occult thing, you know. There's there are eight pillars, you know, in pairs. So that's four. The number four is here. We can all see there's a pyramid on the roof here. And of course it's octagonal because there are eight pillars, you know. The only thing I'm missing here is the number three. I don't see it, and it should be there. It is somewhere. I just don't see it. Maybe it's on the ground, because it's always number three and the number four. As the side of the pyramid, it represents number three, Isis, Horus and Seth. And the base is number four, the four elements. So, I don't know if there's something on the... No, it looks pretty horrible. Excuse me. Excuse my French. Horrible. Little village everywhere. So I just kebab my way around the world again. I just went to the kebab place and you know, I said assalamu alaikum, can you give me some food, you know. So I gave me kebab and some a lot of other things. Real nice people. They're real, you know, like real Muslims with a beard and all that. Real serious guy. They even gave me the book. You know, I'm gonna read a little bit in there. Octagon, yes. In the same red and white colors of the Templars of Switzerland. So we give you an order now, stop. It's an order, stop, get your hands up, you know. So this is the French Horus. The rooster on top of the obelisk. And the obelisk stands for Osiris. And the rooster, Horus, is his son. And here it says les morts, mort pour la France. They're all, you know, all these wars of the Horus matrix, all dead, you know, they all died for the Horus matrix. So the Isis, the witches, they got all the power. That's why Horus is on top of the obelisk, you know, like the sperm on top of the phallic symbol, the descendants, you know, the what else to say? Well, you get it by now, eh? See, it's sort of a swastika. And here, you got four of these things here, from here to here, which I've already shown to you with the board I made is the octagon, you know. It's the same particle like this one here. It's this particle here in it. So... Oh, this looks pretty horrible, doesn't it now, eh? So, you know, so let's have a analyze it. You got this thing in the middle, and here's every time 4, 4, 4. So the number 4 is here. On the pillars, there's 3. Oh, it's also 4, sorry. Yeah,
So there are four. The bottom of the square of the pyramid, that's four for the four elements. And it's divided by this thing here. So on this side there are three. And that's the side of the pyramid, Isis, Horus and Seth. And this thing divides it, the number four. And on the other side is seven. So three and four altogether make seven, which is the holy number for these guys. Yeah? Which is also taken over in the Bible, sort of, you know. And which is not really very divine. It's all, you know, it's pharaonic. So here there are seven, divided by this thing where the number four is on it, and there are three. So that makes three, four, seven. It's all there, the numbers of the pyramid. So three and four, three the side of the pyramid, together with four, the square where it's all on, it makes makes seven. So, and why this is here, there was probably also a reason. I can't see it yet, you know. I should be like in a chopper, you know, hovering over it to see that. It's really awful, real awful atmosphere on this thing. It's always on a roundabout. I mean, what are you going to do on a roundabout? You don't want to live here. You're not going to put a house there or something. What are you going to do with it? And everybody is passing it, so, you know, it's quite obvious. Right. Well, let's go to the motorway. So it's a pretty awful thing here, roundabout in Beaurepaire. Yeah, there it says Beaurepaire, yeah, over there. Let's see if I can get it. Beaurepaire. Yeah. And yeah, so here you can see the other one is just like hidden behind that one there. So there are, you know, you can see there are 10 altogether, 7, 3, 4, it's all there. The pyramid, pharaohs, they're ruling. So, you know, there's this roundabout here. And behind there, there's another one, you see, with also sort of all these antennas and pillars on it. There's another one. What? I'm not going there, I'm not going to count it for you, it's always the same thing. It looks like this is one fourth, the white part is one fourth of the whole thing, so there's the number four. And what's left, you know, this is three. So, you know, it's all there, and a couple of X's. It's all over. There's my petrol station where the pyramid is. I slept about, I don't know, there where that house is there. It's absolute gorgeous here. I wanted to go further south, but it's fine here, you know, so I'm just chilling out here. With some guys, you know, when I was kebopping my way around, they gave me the book here. And they didn't let me go before I, you know, accepted the book. So I'm gonna chill out and just read a little bit in it, you know, and see what it's about, you know. I still got some kebab left here, the bread here and all that. So I've got water, I've got everything. Last night there were some heavy duty looking cops there in the petrol station. So I saluted them and I say, bonsoir, cher chevalier du roi. I told them, good evening. My dear knights of the king, pharaoh in fact, yeah. Windmills, so that's me, Don Quixote, fighting the windmills. Now this is what I adore about France, you know, you find all this, it looks like the Jerry's left it when they forgot it when they left, you know. The animals love it, you know, it gives a place for animals, you know, and insects and nice with the tree, it's really adorable picture, you know. In Switzerland, if you will do so, your neighbors will call up the cops and they will come and give you a fine, and you have to take it away and pay some more for it, because they want Switzerland, you know, to be clean, you know. Never you'd see something like this in Switzerland. The moment you cross the frontiers, although you have to pass Alsace first,
But then a little bit further, you see, you can grasp these sort of things. It's fabulous, you know. It gives you now a grasp of the past, you know. So that's why I was. That's why I am. I'm just sitting there. So, but then I thought, hey, Jerry's are, you know, like hiding in the bush here. So let's have a look. And actually, you know, the system, the American system, it originally came from France, you know, the New World Order. Well, okay, France was the first country where they expanded it to. It came from Switzerland, of course. But there's the Templars, where they spoke French mostly, the aristocracy. They expanded this idea first to France with the French Revolution. So this is why Frenchy gave the Statue of Liberty to Yankee, see? But it's all from Switzerland, of course. There's no doubt about that. Well, let's have a closer look at the... great, man. Make a hot rod out of it. Nice. What is it? A cherry tree? No, before that, there was a real nice cherry tree, but it's too early. We're still in April. Oh, look at it. Right. There's still numbers on it. And yeah. But then again, you know, the French population doesn't seem to be willing to cooperate with the New World Order. Many of them won't. Well, they all have to work, you know, or many. There are, I don't know, 3.5 million unemployed. Because of the tax evasion, you know, they're all stealing money, go to Switzerland. 80 billion euros every year. So here somewhere I'm reading about the King Aziz of Saudi Arabia. You know, he did his work like in translating the book. So it's Pharaoh again, the aristocracy, just like everywhere else. So I already feel like throwing it away. But then again, you know, are the Christians different? You know, the King James Bible and Romans 13, where it says, you know, you should obey the New World Order. It really says that, you know. So all these books, you know, they've all been infiltrated by the by Pharaoh. You know, they all got their fingers in it. Christianity and Islam and everywhere else. You know, it's everywhere the same thing. So, but there must be a creator, you know. It's not possible. I mean, now it's nice sunny weather, you know, we can just sit here, you know, and all the time you have to put on shoes, otherwise our extraterrestrial feet, they hurt, put on clothes, you have to boil and heat up everything, otherwise we can't digest it, so, and we're not adapted to this planet, you know, we're not from here. Tonight it's getting cold again, you know, so I have to put it on a dust bag, I need a tent. We're not from here. But in these books, there's nothing about it, you know? Yeah. Maybe I'm the only prophet around. Look, there it is. Fleur de lis. Here. Right there. Fleur de lis, symbol of the aristocracy. And I just read that the Jews are the beloved people in the Quran as well. God's Israel is God, the children of Israel are the God's beloved people. So, here it says, yeah. And it's called Al-Baqarah, the cow. It says, same thing. So here, this is interesting. Here I read, like historically, this is interesting. So here I read in the Muslim book, in the Quran, that... the Surah 14, called Abraham, it says how Pharaoh, he killed the sons of the people, but not the daughters. So this is definitely the Horus Matrix. And I never read in the book that I read the entire thing here in French, and I never read nowhere that Muhammad is the last prophet. So we had Sina van Rensburg in South Africa. He really was a prophet. So. I never read it nowhere. It's not a violent book either. It's not at all. It only says one time in the entire book that if a woman doesn't obey, you can correct her. Only one time. It's not violent at all, and it's just like it's a praise to the Lord. It's a lot of repeating. It doesn't really say very much. But interesting to read it. And here it says once more in the Surah 28, number 4, it says how Pharaoh, he slit the throat of the man, of the sons, and he let the women alive. You know, that's typically what the aristocracy did, you know. In Europe, that's what they always did. That's what Pharaoh's doing, you know, with the huge prime noctis, you know, injecting their pharaonic genetics into our women, which we find now all over. You know, that's what the war is about. You know, you kill the man and their sons, and you keep the daughters, and they're very sly, these pharaohs. For me, this is very interesting, these two things, in the Surah 28 and the other one. And and here then, you know, once more, this is here the symbol, the fleur de lis. There it is. This is the fleur de lis. Right. So I'm here in a farm. A guy took me hitchhiking. It's really old here. It's in the middle of nowhere, sort of. Interesting. So here on the petrol station you see the pyramid with the all-seeing eye there, you know. There's the all-seeing eye. And it says Sa, meaning the king in Pharaonic. There's another sort of a pyramid with the Templar symbol underneath. Now once more, it's just unbelievable. So we're in the motorway here. Already been here for 2 days.
Big hair. Having fun.
So here's another funny logo. Same colors, the pharaonic colors, red, white and blue. Already explained that to you. Three. The blue ones are 3 for Isis, Horus and Seth. The red ones are 6. 3 times 6 is 666. There are 9 gods of the pharaohs. La Dauphinoise, it means the firstborn queen in this case, in French. Le Dauphin, that's the primogenitura. You know, the firstborn. You know, it's all there, you know. And yesterday I talked with a Norwegian guy. I forgot to film it. No, I always forget to film it, you know, talking to people. And he said he knew Breivik. This is the way he said it. You know, real funny. Breivik. And he was in school with him. And he said he had a nose job done. He had a real big nose. And he had it, you know, he had it fixed. He was kind of weird already then, you know. And he was a class below him. So I'm really sorry I forgot to film it. You know, they have some sort of a festivity here. This is the Lucky Luke guys. Some old cars here, very nice. I don't know what the name of the town is anyway. You know, it's next to the Saint-Rambert, the petrol station on the motorway. But what is interesting, you know, this festivity here is not, it's not very interesting. What is interesting is this here. It's the mayor's office, the ones who are ruling, the pharaohs. And of course there's the world domination here 2 times, like a pair of bulls here. And this is the joining, it's like a moustache. And I've never seen it before like this. It's like, it looks like a pyramid if you look at from the top, you know, if you look like from an airplane. And it is the sun, it's also the sun hieroglyph. In the middle, there's a round thing and 2 bars on each side. And there's probably more, you know, but it's raining, so I put away my cam. Yeah, vive la France.
Ah, mais vive la France, et vive la France, vive la France.
Mais en tout cas, c'est moi, c'est mon rêve de découvrir l'Égypte. Et pour moi, la France, on se fait guider. Et pourtant, je suis français. C'est pas méchant, mais j'aime pas être filmé. Non, c'est pas méchant.
It's the mayor's office, you know, in some village. I don't even know what the name is. An obelisk. You can see the Templar's cross. Here's the Rusa, which symbolizes the French Horus. And on top here is a fleur de lis, symbol of the aristocracy. It's all here, you know. It's they even dare to say, you know, freedom. It says, freedom, equality, and fraternity. And here, you know, is a lion. So they're part of it, you know. Symbol of the aristocracy. Still, this aristocracy ruling. I'm here in a church in Beaurepaire. And everywhere it shows the Swiss cross or the Templar's cross. It's like here as well. And there. It's like everywhere. The Swiss cross. There it is again. So here's some stuff from his grandfather, who was in the First World War, and a hand grenade from the First World War, and these sort of things, they made it after the war. So this is, he was in the Battle of Verdun in 1916, here 1915. So all this is like, this is the Horus Matrix, you know. Yeah, Switzerland, of course, Switzerland on it as always. But what I really wanted to show you is this. If you look at it like this, you know, it's octagonal. These guys are so obsessed with their numbers, you know, these war makers, that they put this the octagon and the number 8 everywhere in their war stories, everything that is, you know, connected with war and killing in the Horus Matrix. Pharaoh's wars, you know, so there are four lines on the outside of the hand grenade. So this is a French hand grenade from the First World War, and he took it off here, the grandfather. And who was in two world wars. And here in this farm, they had a woman during the Second World War hiding here from Alsace. Nice flower. Idea what it is. It's sort of a tree. And here, of course, is the Grail. Our blood is here, our descendants is here, and here's Isis. You know, the Per Isis, descendants of Isis. So the Masons, they put it especially here, you know, they just glue it from an old building and they put it like on this new building. And here's this pyramid again.
Regarde tous les avions qu'il y a.
Oui. Oh, wow. So this guy here, Frenchy here, he has this special thing here because he was working at the airport and all the airplanes are in it. And just before, there were all the chemtrails. It was a real nice sunny day. And now the chemtrails came and it became all cloudy. Well, there's another one, you know. And just before we had just two airplanes, one of them was in his machine, in his thing here, which shows all the airplanes, you know, in the sky, and one of them was not in it. So that means it was not an airplane. Must have been, you know, like in the World Trade Center, must have been a laser projection, you know, of a, I don't know what, you know, maybe a UFO, but must have been. And now it's getting, you know, it's getting all
chemtrails, you know, you know the chemtrails, and it's gonna be all cloudy, and I think in an hour it will be all cloudy and the sun will be going away. You know, it's already like the sky is getting milky. But you know, this guy by accident, he was here working for the at the airport, so he got this thing in his phone, and one of the airplanes, there were just two before, was not in his machine, so it was not an airplane. See what I mean? So these things, they look like airplanes, but they're not airplanes. We just had it on his in his display of the this special program only issued to people working at the airport.
Donc là, tu vois, nous, le point, on est là.
Oui.
Et là, normalement, il y a un avion qui est juste au-dessus, Marseille, tu vois. C'est un avion comme ça.
Il y a même de numéros et et d'où il vient, d'où ils vont. Ah.
Tu peux même mettre en 3D, après tu peux mettre une image, ce qu'il vaut.
Attends, tu vas juste filmer le...
Voilà, donc
là, ça, c'est l'avion qui est juste en haut, là.
Voilà, et après je fais ça, donc là, il va nous dire d'où il vient.
Ouais.
Et où il va.
Ouais.
Mais il n'y en a pas.
Mais il n'y en a pas. Aïe, 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 aïe. Et l'autre aussi, qui était, on l'a vu, mais il n'était pas là-dedans. Mmh. Donc, c'est-à-dire, les chemtrails, hein, shit. Tout est menti, folks. Sorry, everything is a lie, folks. History is a lie. They're destroying the Earth. We're all gonna die. Right, chemtrails. Ah oui, est-ce qu'il est dedans, hein?
J'ai rien dit. Bon, Franck, tu aimes les patates?
Non, je vais y aller. Je vais y aller.
Pourquoi?
Ben, je vais chercher des hommes.
Donc, ça, il va à Munich?
Il vient de Lisbonne et il va à Munich.
Ah, il y a même l'avion là.
Et c'est celui-là d'avion.
Oui. Ok.
Voilà.
Ouais. Mais tout à l'heure, il y avait donc un qui volait là-bas et il n'était pas marqué dessus.
Non.
Donc.
Celui-là, il fait à 426 km. Il va à 426 km/h. Latitude 45 000. Longitude.
420 km seulement?
Ouais.
Parce qu'à cette hauteur.
Là, c'est marqué 427 KTS. KTS, je ne sais pas ce que c'est. KTS.
Donc à cette hauteur, il devrait voler à 850 km de l'heure en fait, parce que ça a 10
mètres. Ouais, mais bon, KTS, c'est pas kilomètre heure, donc je sais pas KTS, c'est quoi la norme, KTS. Ah,
c'est pour les ovnis. Shit. Always three for Isis, Horus and Seth. Three nights, three white lines and three black lines. Hell of a lot of chemtrails today. So apparently this is an old Roman track. I looked up here, as they told me. No. The Roman eagle is still there. Two of them. Pharaoh. SwiSSy. Nussdorfer. So there's another castle here. SwiSSy living here. In France. The all-seeing eye. Sort of a French game for the old people. Well, playing ball, real good at it. Switzerland. Some here like south of Lyon, in the middle of France, you can still see Switzerland. The Swiss, you know, SwiSSy is everywhere. Another church here in Haute-Rive, full of Swiss crosses, the Templar crosses. Even where Jeanne d'Arc is standing, it's full of it, really. There's another one, it's everywhere. SwiSSy is ruling everywhere. And there. Everywhere. And here, the Pope. It looks quite real. E.
and they're everywhere. Above Jesus, his mother, is a Swiss cross. Can you believe it? And Jeanne d'Arc, because she was caught by the Swiss mercenaries and sold, you know, to the English. Well, there's the sun hieroglyph vertically on both sides on an old bakery here in Haute-Rive. I don't know, I just got arrested by the cops, you know, for opening my mouth about the attacks in Paris, you know. So I'm gonna exfiltrate. Of course, you never exfiltrate by the big roads. You go where it's green, you know, so I'm gonna cross the dip somewhere. It's a bit high here. Over there, it looks pretty good, so I'm going over there. So French took me hitchhiking here, you know, in the old farm. And this reminded me of, here's a Lego toys, you know, it's a pirate ship, you see. And actually, all of a sudden, after the Crusades, you know, there were a lot of pirate ships, and they were fighting, actually, the King of England, you know, and the Royal Navy. Because this is the New World Order, just like the symbol of the Masons. And because the Templars, they dug out the Templars' treasure from the pyramids, where they found a lot of skulls and bones of the Pharaoh. So this is actually, hello Mr. Pharaoh. And so this is what happened, you know, partially. Apart from, you know, the Templar ships going to Scotland, you know, having the Scottish Rite written in two different ways. You know, the Templar's treasure went to Switzerland. You know, what to do with all the ships, and this war between the Old World Order and the Primogenitura, the first son, of the, you know, the king, the lineage of the king, it went on, and this is what happened. You know, the Templar ships, they put the New World Order, Freemasons, skull and bones symbol on their ships, fighting the Old World Order. And this is why the Nazis, they took the same thing, you know, the SS. As I already told you, that's, you know, skull and bones, and SS, it means ISIS, because it's only the consonants being written in, pharaonic demotic, just like in Hebrew or in Arabic. So, this is just a New World Order ship fighting the British King and the British Empire, you know. And, yeah, and all the, you know, both world wars were a war between the Old World Order and the New World Order, and we had to bleed for it. So this is what's really happening. It just reminded me, maybe I never told you like this before, but when I saw the ship, you know, I got so many things in my mind, you know, I just forgot about it maybe. So, well, here it is. Right. That's me, it's my tent there. And some people living here, you know, in the middle of nature, you know. There they build a hut here. And so they took me hitchhiking, and down there's the river. There's a nice river. It's called the Lignon. And French are living there. So young people, you know. Just want to keep down the living costs, you know, so they don't have to work too much. So, speel er veel mee al interieur?
Wat is het even?
A wood stove, everything. He made it all himself out of a lorry. Salut Maxime. This is a magic forest, you know, it's all grass in the forest, you know, that's pretty rare. All grass. I just saw a deer hopping around here. Beautiful. So the guys, you know, they're going to have a free party, you know, with about 100 people, even people coming from Berlin and everywhere. And I don't like parties. I'm going to sleep in the forest, in the magic forest there. There's nobody around here, you know. We really drove for about 2 hours. Nothing, you know. Look at it, isn't it beautiful? A forest full of grass, you know. Isn't it nice to put the tent, you know? This is in Le Massif Central. It's a plateau in the middle of France. It's really very, very big. And it's about more than 1,000 meters high. It's already cold here, and in winter it gets very cold here. So, you know, everywhere you look here is forest, you know. It's on the other side as well, yeah. So there they're gonna have the free party there. And so this is south, very far south of Paris. I don't know, maybe 600 kilometers, or I don't know, 700 maybe. The magic forest. Oh, I should have been careful here with this, all these dead branches overhead. Oh yeah, and all dead branches lying everywhere, you know, they all fall down here. Yeah, so this wasn't a very good idea. Trees falling down here. Very bad idea. Well, I survived. Bye bye, everyone. Salut. See you later.
Yo yo. Il t'arrive sur l'axe.
A nuclear plant in France here. Horrible. I wouldn't like to live here. And they got a windmill next to it. I don't get it. Why a windmill next to it? You know. This is the Rhône, the river. Nice clouds here. Whoa. Salut, Charles.
Salut. Heureux de t'avoir rencontré.
Ah oui, moi aussi. C'était la folie. On est un peu fous tous les deux.
Ouais. C'est ça qui est bon.
Oui. So this is the lake of Annecy. It looks like entirely like being in Switzerland.
A little polka.
So this is a French instrument from the 10th century.
Yeah, that's how far back they can trace it, yeah.
How do you call it again?
Hurdy-gurdy, or the viol à roue, violin with the wheel.
Fantastic.
Yeah. and then we...